so I hope you're in for it. If you are a visitor, please fill out a visitor card, which should be in your pews, and you can put that in the offering tray as it goes around. A few announcements we have today are, the first one is, we have our Harvest Festival at our church happening on Saturday, October 29th, from 6 to 8 p.m., and Caitlin is going to give us more details about that in a little bit. But on Friday, the 28th, the Harvest Festival is happening at Fort Lewis Elementary School right beside us. So if you are interested in helping with that or bringing anything, there's a sign-up sheet outside on the bulletin board, as well as a sign-up sheet for Saturday, and you can fill that out. And then we have a congregational meeting on Sunday, October 30th, and that is directly following worship. And you'll be voting on board officers, elders, deacons, and budget. Saturday, November 19th, is the church garden sale at Bake Sale, and that is from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. And does anyone else have any other announcements? Caitlin, would you like to speak?
Just a reminder that this coming Saturday is our Harvest Festival from 6 to 8, as Hannah had said. If you have not signed up for chili, candy, dessert, to decorate your car, we really need cars to be decorated. I am the only one. So if you can please decorate a car, it would be great. You can sign up. I need to take the sheet home today so I can kind of get a head count of everything to make sure we have enough. So if you can please do that before you leave church today, it would be great. Thanks.
And you can also email me back. I got a few emails, but if you are willing to do or sign up for Trunk or Treat. Last year we had some really great cars, so hopefully we can have that again for all the kids to. And the kids dress up, so they can dress up in their Halloween costumes and go around. Yeah. Okay, they're going to make a trip to the Ram House this week, so anyone who has any shoes, please bring them by the church. Is that good? And then the parents' meeting is today after church, so we will be supplying lunch for all of the parents and the family. So please, please come out to that. We'll have Miss Anita, our music person, there, as well as all of the church ministry people, so we can get some input from you guys about what you would like to be singing. Any other announcements? Okay, and hope you enjoy our service.
Thank you. earlier I handed out some papers with some Bible verses on them. They have numbers on them. So who has number one? You're going to read it and describe it. So can you do that for me?
Colossians 3:20. Children, obey your parents in everything, for this pleases the Lord. I feel like I say something like this a lot at home, probably just this morning. But for me, it means that respect and love for God and Jesus starts at home with your parents.
And who has number two?
Psalm 113, verse 9. He settles the childless woman in her home, the childless woman in her home, as a happy mother of her children. Praise the Lord. And I think when I was growing up, how I knew I had a home to go to. I knew my mother would be waiting for me when I got home. I knew my father would be home. And I think of all the children today who do not have all those blessings. And I think of all that we need to do to try to provide for them a home, a parents, and all the blessings I received when I was growing up.
Who has number three?
Hosanna to the Son of David. They were indignant. Do you hear what these children are saying? They asked him. Yes, replied Jesus. Have you never read from the lips of children and infants, you, Lord, have called forth your praise? I think to me what this being said here is there are two different groups of people hearing exactly the same word. The children were listening to what Jesus had to say, and the religious leaders were listening to what Jesus had to say. They had two different completely reads on it. One group heard what he had to say with love, without prejudice in their hearts, and the children were able to recognize him as the Son of God. The religious leaders who had an agenda were indignant.
Who has number five?
Exodus 20, verse 12. Honor your father and your mother so that you may live long in the land that the Lord your God is giving you. And I think what this means is, as a child, you got your training wheels on to be a good Christian. You learn to love one another, to respect each other, to care for one another, to give selflessness in the task we're doing. And I think that that's what this means to me.
Six. Who has number six? You do?
Deuteronomy 11:19. Teach them to your children, talking about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road, when you lie down and when you get up. And I think this means your children learn from you at starting at your home in everything that you say and everything that you do. Teach them how to live their life.
Who has seven?
Second Timothy 3:14-15. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and have become convinced of, because you know those whom you have learned it, and how from infancy you have known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. I think speaking to the gathered community that, like all of us here, we learn from our days of infancy through the teachers within the church. We learn the scriptures, and because of the scriptures that we learn, hopefully we are able to live wise lives and understand our salvation through our faith.
And who last has number 8?
Ephesians chapter 6, verses 1 through 4. Children, obey your parents in the Lord. This is right. Honor your father and mother, so that it may go well with you, and that you may enjoy long life on earth. Fathers and mothers, do not exasperate your children. Instead, bring them up in the training and instruction of the Lord. First and foremost, this means my children need to behave and listen to us. But outside of that, it also means that parents have obligations you may have children in a community of faith.
Thank you.
Yes.
Very good. So, children are a gift from God. They are the heritage of the Lord. God tells us to obey our parents, for this makes God very happy. God tells us to provide and teach us his commandments so we can one day go to heaven and so we can be good people on earth. Children are a blessing, and we are all children in the kingdom of God. So if you have paper, can I have it,
three nights there, and then come back and do my rehab here.
prayers for Terry, who's having this knee replaced. Any others?
I have a joy. I get a beer on Tuesday. I'm going to the Parkway. And my car's messed up, but God protected me, and I really appreciate that. So, yes. I have a tremendous joy, and this is the most appropriate Sunday to tell this news. My sister is going to be a grandma. Our niece, Brooke, is expecting a boy on April 17th, and we are just delighted.
Kathy Jones is having knee surgery tomorrow, so she needs a group.
That was good. I mentioned last week during the sermon that Tammy and I have been going through classes to become foster parents. We are definitely asking for a lot of prayers. The classes themselves are pretty rigorous, and once we get through the classes and get a placement, it'll be tough. It'll be good. It'll be a blessing, but it's going to be hard, so we ask for your prayers. They have told us in the classes not to make a decision about whether or not we're going to follow through with it until we get to the end of the class. So we ask for your prayers as we face those decisions as well.
Safe, warm, stimulating environments to spark love
feel the curiosity of our youngest children as they scribble with crayons, pet the hamster, and try to taste the Play-Doh. We pray especially for those providers who are underpaid and undervalued, for those parents who can't find quality, affordable to take care for their children while they work, and for the children whose potential is squelched in poor care. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
We pray for the teachers, Cover and Choctaw, who devote themselves to educating our children and helping them flourish to their potential. For their dedication, imagination, and conquer, we give you thanks. We pray especially for those teachers who have given up on themselves or on the children, who feel unsafe, those who feel unappreciated. Lord, in our mercy, hear our prayer.
We pray for students gripping pencils as they strive to learn, especially those faced with the challenges of disability, unsafe schools, low expectations from their parents, teachers, and selves, and inadequate resources. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Thank you.
In the same night, Jesus took the cup, poured it, and said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Drink it in remembrance of me."
We pray with me. God of peace, as we share this cup, may we feel your peace. Help us to spread your peace to everyone we meet. Amen.
Responsible for what has been entrusted to our care. We are called to love and share what we have, that we have, that all of God's children can be safe, have food to eat, a place to call home. Let us give now of our gifts and offerings, remembering every gift is precious to God, whether small or large.
May these gifts be blessed to build your kingdom for all generations. Amen.
Matthew 22:37-39. Why do you think he will get unconditional love out of earthly people? If you think that, discard it from your mind, because it will never happen. I promise you, you will never get true contentment, even out of your closest companion. And I'm sorry to say, you will never get contentment out of your spouse. You can't be content with the world and be content with him. It's one or the other. If you are content with him, you'd rather be with him in heaven than here. If you are content with the world, then you would rather be here suffering than spending eternity with him. I would hope you would be content with him instead of this world, because as beautiful as creation is, this world is an evil place. Here's probably by far my favorite Bible verse about love, and you might know what they are. From 1 Corinthians 13, verses 4 through 8. Love is patient and kind. It doesn't envy or boast. It is not jealous or conceited or proud. Love is not ill-mannered or selfish or irritable. Love does not keep a record of wrongs. Love is not happy with evil, but is content with the truth. Love never gives up, and its faith, hope, and patience never fail. Love is eternal. Also from verse 13, meanwhile, these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Who do you say that I am? You are the way, the truth, and the life. John 14, 6. You are the resurrection. John 11, 25. And the Son of God. Now that we have been put right with God through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Romans 5, verse 1. Christ is the reason we live. He is who we live for. Acts 16, verses 31 through 32 says, believe in the Lord Jesus, and you will be saved, you and your family. Then they preached the word of the Lord to him and to all the others in the house. The only way to get to heaven and God is through Jesus. So many of us think, oh, all we have to do is do good deeds throughout our life and boom, we're in heaven. But it doesn't work that way. You have to believe that Jesus is the Son of the living God, that he rose him from the dead 3 days later, and once he rose, he went to heaven and prepared a place for you. 9 times out of 10, one has probably heard it said, don't eat a lot of bread. It's very fattening for you. I agree with that to a certain extent. But our sweet Savior proclaims to us in John 6:35 that he is the bread of life, and whoever comes to him will never be hungry. Those who believe in him will never be thirsty. Jesus was someone who lived on earth as a human, just like you and I do. The only difference between him and us is he never committed a sin. We sin on a daily basis. That is what separates us from him. Christ loved everyone. He healed the sick, opened the eyes of the blind, made the deaf hear, allowed the lame to walk again. Jesus is so anxious to have a relationship with you. It's up to you to want it. It is never too late to receive him. When you accept him as the Lord and controller of your life, he will receive you as a disciple of Christ. Once you accept him into your heart, you have been declared as child of the one and only true King. For that reason, go, proclaim the good news, and make disciples of all nations.
Amen.
like to come and follow him by confessing faith in him for the first time and joining together with our church, or by rededicating your life, we invite you to come forward and do so as we stand and sing our hymn of invitation, Shine, Jesus, Shine. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.